Before we going for eye physiology, first we try to understand the structure of the eyeball. What are the layers present in the eyeball? The structure of the eyeball. It's the cornea of the eye. Cornea is attached with this is the sclera. This layer is sclera. Sclera is continue backward. Sclera continue backward with the optic nerve. The optic nerve. Optic nerve. Nerve having the outermost layer nerve is epineurium. Epineurium. No. Sclera attached with this epineurium. This optic nerve. It's a cornea. It's a junction point between cornea and the sclera, and this junction known as sclerocorneal junction. Another name for this is a limbus. What is a limbus? Limbus is the junction between cornea and sclera. It's an eyeball, and this part of eyeball is a white part of eyeball. It's a cornea is totally cornea transparent. Cornea is transparent, and the sclera is a opaque thing, opacity, not allow light to pass. So cornea is totally, it's the outer covering of the eyeball. If we move inside, if we move the second layer here, it's a uveal tract. It's a uveal tract. It's a uveal tract here. This uveal tract in front is not complete. We having gap here. This gap, this part of uveal tract is iris. Close to iris here, we having structure here. This structure known as ciliary body. This structure known as ciliary body for eczema production. The uveal tract is the ciliary body. And this part of the uveal tract is known as choroid. Known as choroid. All these three parts is a choroidal part. It's the iris, it's a full uveal tract. And this hole present in center, this opening, is the pupil. This opening known as, it's a pupil. It's a layer present, the second layer. This layer is a vascular layer. Sclera composition, connective tissue, mainly collagen, and this is uveal tract. This full uveal tract, in uveal tract we having three parts. Number one, iris in front. Next we having ciliary body. Next structure we having choroid. Choroid is a choroidal part. The choroidal part is a posterior part of uveal tract. It's the anterior part of uveal tract. Full tract known as uveal tract. If the any person having disease related to uveal tract is known as uveitis. It's known as uveitis. And the choroidal layer, this choroidal layer is containing, it's a vascular layer. This full uveal tract containing blood vessels is also known as vascular layer. And also having pigment. It's a pigment layer and vascular layer of the eyeball. It's a uveal tract. It's a uveal tract. It's the pupil. It's the iris, ciliary body, it's the choroid, it's the iris, ciliary body, it's the choroid. Okay, next I draw the next structure here. Here we having lens. Y convex shape here is a lens. Lens connected to ciliary body using these ligament. These ligaments are suspensory ligaments. In center here we having lens. In center, lens, and these ligaments are suspensory ligaments. These are the suspensory ligament. And it's your ciliary body. We already done before. It's your ciliary body. And now the eye have the two structure here. The two main parts, the front to lens from here till here, and the area behind the lens from here till here. Now these two part, the first part is anterior compartment. Anterior compartment of the eyeball, and this part is posterior compartment. It's a posterior compartment of the eyeball. In posterior compartment, what are the things here? We have jelly-like substance in posterior compartment. And that jelly-like substance in posterior compartment known as vitreous humor. In the anterior to lens, we having here water, and that water known as aqueous humor. So eyeball, the shape of eyeball, the anterior compartment is maintained by the aqueous humor, and the posterior compartment eyeball, the shape full wall is the shape is maintained by vitreous humor. Okay, the next layer is your neural layer, nerve layer. This optic nerve enter to eyeball and change to cup shape. It's a cup shape layer. This layer is a cup shape, and this cup shape layer is a retina. This full layer is a retina. They draw with different color, with black color because a bit dim here. You can see here's a retina. It's a cup shape structure. Retina is an innermost layer. It's an innermost layer of the eyeball. It's a cup shape. In front of this retina, here we can see here easily is a vitreous humor. It's a cup shaped retina. Retina, you can see this is a thickness of the retina from here till here. This is a full thickness of the retina. And this part of retina is the inside of retina, and this part of retina is the outside of retina. Is external part of retina, it's internal part of retina. The retina inside the full thickness, retina have further the more 10 layers. Let me talk about the what are the layers present inside the retina. The layers of retina. The layers of retina from if you start from outside, then the first layer is must be choroidal layer. The choroidal layer here in the choroidal layer already mentioned here. In the choroidal layer we having pigments there. Then external layer of retina is outside. It's external layer. Then the internal layer of retina are more close toward the vitreous. It is attached to the vitreous part. Okay. Now I move on next thing about this. We just discussed about now anterior compartment. Okay, what are the anterior compartment having two chamber? The anterior compartment of eye having two chamber, two spaces here is the anterior chamber and posterior chamber. The aqueous humor is produced by ciliary body, then travel behind the iris and then enter to pupil. then enter to pupil from here. This is the same side here, okay? The ecosystem, the this part, the space, what's the posterior chamber? The space between lens and iris. What is the anterior chamber? The space between iris and cornea. Space between iris and cornea, and space between lens and iris is the posterior chamber of eyeball, is the anterior chamber of eyeball. So these two chambers are responsible for the flow of aqueous humor. For the flow of aqueous humor. If I draw this part separately here, try to understand the disease, first disease related with the aqueous humor. The condition here we having the cornea, behind here we having the lens, so cornea here is the lens, front of this lens here we having it's the iris and iris attached with these are the ciliary body, it's a ciliary body here. And next layer here going upward is a sclera. Sclera, cornea, ciliary body, is the lens, is the iris. Okay, now try to understand posterior chamber, anterior chamber. And this space is a posterior chamber. And this space is the anterior chamber. If we draw this side, it's the iris also here. You can see this space, the space between iris is the pupil. It's the pupil. So, ecosystem produced from the ciliary body is a water. Produced from the ciliary body and this way water then passing through this pupil and then going to this junction here. You can see here. It's a limbus here. It's a limbus, it's a cornea and sclera junction. And this angle you can see, this is the angle between, this angle present between iris and cornea. At this angle, cornea, a radial angle, at this angle is a sclera. Sclera have the big vein here. The sclera is a canal-like structure, the sclera, and at top of sclera we having episcleral veins there. We having scleral veins here. And this canal-like structure is known as canal of Schelling. Canal, you can pronounce here canal of Schelling also, canal of Schelling also. The canal of Schelling, the ecosystem start produced by the ciliary body, then passing through this pupil, anterior to lens, and then passing just behind the iris, passing through this pupil, then enter to anterior chamber, then absorb here. So this ecosystem is a water, is a produced from here and then absorption here. So what's the function of ecosystem? One thing, it maintain intraocular pressure. It control the size of this chamber. It maintain the pressure inside the chamber, and this ecosystem also responsible for nutrition. The inner layer, there's an inner layer here. This inner layer is a cornea here. If I extend this cornea behind, then we have sclera here. It's again angle here, okay? It's a corneoiridial angle. So at the corneoiridial angle, we're having the structure canal of Schelling. This is a claim, it's a canal-like structure, canal of Schelling. So ecosystem maintain nutrition and controlling its pressure. So normally the ecosystem production, the production must equal to absorption. There's a constant thing here. If you produce ecosystem, then there must be absorption of that ecosystem. Ecosystem production must be equal to ecosystem absorption. If the ecosystem production, if the production too much and absorption is less. Now here two pathologies here. One, ecosystem production is high and ecosystem absorption is low. What happened here? The ecosystem is a water. If you produce more and absorb less, what happened here? Here the pressure, the intraocular pressure, the pressure inside the eyeball in the anterior compartment will increase. the pressure in anterior compartment will increase. This equals him putting pressure on the RS, then this RS, then now putting pressure. Here we having ciliary ligament was done in above picture I draw here, above drawing. Here the suspensor ligament. Now if you have very high level of eicosahedron here, this eicosahedron can exert pressure on the lens. This pressure ultimately the shifted toward the back side behind the lens by vitreous humor, just behind vitreous humor. And here we have the cup shaped structure is your retina, cup shaped structure your retina. So now the pressure is exerted on the retina. What have retina? Retinal vessels, the retinal artery. Retinal artery enter to and supply the different layers of retina. The retinal artery, now the issue with the retina can now blood supply can be blocked, the ischemia of retina. Now the person can be blind easily. And that this condition in which the eicosahedron is increasing, and when eicosahedron is increased in the eyeball, it may be due to more production, it may be due to decrease less absorption. So if this condition known as eicosahedron production or less absorption, the pressure is increasing in the eyeball, and this disease known as glaucoma. It's a glaucoma. What's a glaucoma? Is increase in intraocular pressure. Increase in intraocular pressure. This glaucoma we can divide into the two categories. There the pathology may be the absorption issue, pathology may be the production issue. This glaucoma we can divide according to anatomical structure is the open angle glaucoma. Open angle glaucoma and close angle glaucoma. Open angle and close angle glaucoma. Open angle glaucoma we further can it may be, it depend upon duration here, the acute development or chronic development. Closer angle glaucoma, acute development, mostly acute stages, or maybe the rarely we having chronic phase also. Okay, the open angle glaucoma and the closed angle glaucoma. What's the main, what the meaning of these two terminology here? It depend upon if this angle is open. If this angle is still normal and the problem still with the absorption and a production issue. Maybe production issue, maybe absorption issue. If this angle is still open, it's not the open angle glaucoma. If this angle is closed, what's the meaning here? I draw the first angle here. Open angle is the meaning of open. It's the cornea. And here we having the iris. And this iris, you can see here, oh, it's iris. Angle is much wide. It's an open angle. This the iris. It's the cornea. What happened in the closed angle? It's the cornea here. And now iris moving much toward the cornea. Now you can see this angle become narrow. If you compare with this angle, is this angle is still wide and open. So this case is an open angle glaucoma, is a narrow angle glaucoma. Narrow angle, close angle or narrow angle. So these are two different category of the glaucoma, if angle is open or angle is the narrow. Open angle glaucoma and narrow angle glaucoma. So due to this glaucoma, what happened? Intraocular pressure is increased, and this intraocular pressure putting pressure, now this pressure shifted toward eicosahedron, then ultimately to retina can be degenerate. So glaucoma can easily lead to blindness. Glaucoma lead to blindness. In open angle glaucoma, if the angle is still open, then the main issue with production. Production is too much. Angle still open. Production is too much. And really with the issue of the absorption, main issue production of eicosahedron. But in the closer angle glaucoma, what happened? The main issue with the absorption, because angle close, absorption is the issue. So we use drug in open angle, different types of drug, in closer angle, different category of drugs. And another condition, okay, the some drug, if we talk about is the pupil here, this pupil, I draw another picture here, is the cornea, is the iris here, is the cornea, is the iris here, cornea and iris, the junction here. If you increase, it's a picture number A. Okay, we see what happened. Picture number B. It's a cornea. It's the iris. Check what happened to the pupil. The pupil, the size of pupil here smaller. You can see here, size smaller. But here you can see the pupil size is much bigger. The pupil here dilated. In diagram B, the pupil here dilated. Dilated pupil, the dilation of pupil, in medical term we use here mydriasis. So any drug or any chemical inducing, you can see here mydriasis. So if you're doing mydriasis, what happened with the angle? The angle become more, what the effect of mydriasis on angle? Angle clause. If angle clause, it can make glaucoma more worse. If already angle clause are there, you giving, if you apply any chemical to a patient using any drug for any other disease and that drug causing mydriasis, it can make worse your glaucoma. Okay, now in the picture C, you see here in this case, picture C is the cornea, is the iris here, is the cornea here, is the iris. Now what happened here, if I make this pupil more narrow, now this angle, the compare the size of this angle, is the angle here, this angle here, or this angle here. Here when we're doing the constriction of pupil, constriction known as meiosis, and during this meiosis, what happened to angle? Angle become a bit wide open. Oh, so drug very helpful here. If help for opening of this angle, this drug can helpful for glaucoma. It can give you relief from glaucoma. This is the main concept behind the meiosis and mydriasis. What is the effect of mydriasis and effect of meiosis on the glaucoma? Okay, this is the condition about the eicosemer. I don't want to talk in much detail. It's just a physiology. You must know what's the eicosemer physiology here, okay? The eicosemer giving nutrition, and what disease related to eicosemer is known as glaucoma. This glaucoma, what happened inside the eyeball is intraocular pressure is increasing. The intraocular pressure increase, why increase? Maybe the production is more, maybe absorption is less. That's why. That's the reason. Then we use medication to help for increase in absorption, help for decrease in production, will help you for treatment of glaucoma. And next, what is the effect of constriction and dilation of the pupil on the angle, and how the chemical they causing constriction or dilation of the pupil, how they interfere with the condition glaucoma? You must try to understand here. You must focus on what's the anatomical changes here. What happened with the angle in dilation? What happened with the angle in meiosis? The angle become more wide during meiosis. The angle become more and more narrow. That's when glaucoma become more worse. And these are chemical help for meiosis. It better for treatment of glaucoma. It's all about the structure of the eyeball. The structure of the eyeball. And next we talk about the other physiology of the cornea, physiology of the lens. So we continue with the vision physiology. We'll talk about the cornea function with the the lens function, how light enter, how refraction there. This is all about the eyeball layer.